This video is about 2x2 factorial designs, how they manipulate and measure certain variables and hold others constant in order to avoid confounding. Now, in any kind of research, we first have to identify the subjects, the organisms who will be responding to the stimuli. In this case, it would be anybody who eats these two sandwiches. We've also got to identify the dependent variable. And in this case, the dependent variable will be the subject's response to these two sandwiches, how well the subjects like the taste. Then we have several independent variables that we're going to measure or manipulate. Now, one independent variable is the type of bread used. This is the sesame seed bun, and here we have a 7-grain whole wheat and other grain bread. So that's one variable, one difference between the sandwiches. We have another independent variable, and that's what I put on the sandwich. The left half of each sandwich has pickle relish. The right half of each sandwich has olives. Now, we're going to put some cheese on each of these sandwiches. Now, it's going to be the same kind of cheese on both sides of the sandwich and the same kind of cheese on each sandwich. So you might say that because the cheese doesn't change, it's a constant. The two independent variables here are the bread and whether we put relish or olives on the bread. Now, if I put all of my relish here on the whole wheat bread, and I put all of my olives here on the sesame seed roll, that would have been a poor design. That would have created confounding, where we really don't know what's causing what. If I prefer the sandwich with the whole wheat bread and the pickle relish better than the sandwich with the sesame seed bun and the olives, is that because of the bread? Or would I put on the bread, olives or pickle relish? I wouldn't know. By using a 2x2 factorial design and using two different kinds of bread and two different kinds of topping on each piece of bread, I have 2x2, four different combinations, and I'll be able to respond and tell you which one I like best. That's going to be the dependent variable. I'm going to put these sandwiches in the microwave, and I'm going to be the organism.